Hey Resinators, so I found another spooky story for spooky season on the subreddit Short Scary Stories. This one has the perfect horror movie ominous feel to it, so you guys have to let me know what you think. Also, stay to the end so that you can see the final results of my newest custom domino set. Alright besties, here we go. The knocking continues, the same sharp, rhythmic pace. The lock is the only thing keeping them out. The cabin belonged to Sam's great-grandfather, and he hadn't used it in years. We were miles from civilization and anyone that could help. It started the moment we pulled up. I felt a sense of dread filling my chest as I stared at the cabin, bathed in shadows from the trees that surrounded it. I pushed the feeling aside, chalking it up to being so far from everything and everyone. But the feeling didn't disappear. If anything, it got stronger. It was Sam who found it. He'd been looking for fishing gear in the cellar. Instead, he found the jar, stuffed with a folded piece of paper and what looked like a twig. He dumped the contents onto the floor, holding the twig in between his fingers. "It's a bone," he said, dropping it into the jar with a clink. "A bone?" Cora asked, crinkling her nose. "A small animal bone, maybe?" Sam said. He shook the dust from the paper, silently reading.
"What's it say?"
Matt asked.
"Just gibberish," he said, attempting to shove it back into the jar.
Cora snatched it, staring at the shaky print. Matt read it aloud over her shoulder. "My wife is not my wife. She ate our dog, crunching his bones in her jaws. She's out there now, still knocking to be let in." There were brown streaks on the paper. Sam put the jar back in the cellar, but the damage, whatever it was, had been done. We'd all felt it. Some sort of ominous countdown. Matt was the first to go. At midnight, he jumped up, mumbling something about his dog, and ran out into the woods. We tried to explain to him that he didn't have a dog, but he ran and ran until the darkness swallowed him up. Cora chased after him, screaming his name. Sam, he left an hour later, swearing he'd heard his little brother calling him. Seth's been dead for 6 years. Sam pushed me when I tried to stop him. I called after him, but he kept running. So I locked the door, sitting on the floor with my back against it. I'd get help in the morning, I reasoned. Then the knocking started.
"Kay, let me in," Matt said.
But his voice was wrong, like he had a mouthful of gravel. I ignored the knocking, and after a while, he left. But the knocking continued.
"Kay,"
Cora said. I could almost hear her smiling. I stayed quiet, and like Matt, she left eventually. Sam began knocking a few moments ago.
"I'm coming in,"
he said, his voice like water bubbling in a drain, broken fingernails scratching at the wood. "I have a few hours until morning, but I know I won't make it, because I can hear whatever that thing is behind the door chuckling in an unmistakable jingling sound. That's when I remembered that Sam has the keys."
Oh, guys. Okay, so I always love reading these scary stories. It's so much fun. I'm always so paranoid while I'm reading it. I'm like looking over my shoulders, scared to death, but it's just so fun. So you guys have to let me know what you think about this story. And let me know if you think OP is going to make it.
Because I know I would be freaking out.
Also, you gotta let me know what you think about the results to my newest custom domino set. So for this one, the customer wanted like a dark maroon red with black. And this one was a lot of fun to make. I love doing the swirls. And they wanted also the black galaxy glitter. So for this one, I had a lot of fun. It was hard for me to decide what color to do for the dots, but I made this like perfect little concoction of silver nail polish and then sparkly black iridescent glitter. So these are the final results. You guys have to let me know what you think. And if you made it all the way here to the end of the video, make sure that you show me some love and drop some black and red emojis to show me that you're a true supporter. All right, besties, I love you so much. Stay safe, stay amazing, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.